Now here we're going to 23 years. This should have been done a long time ago.
In the tiny Texas town of Mount Calm, private investigator William Deere is stirring up a storm of evidence in one of America's most high-profile crimes.
My quest now, and has always been in this case, is to seek justice.
That quest came to life 1,500 miles from the LA crime scene at the end of this dusty country road. On an eccentric ranch in this giant warehouse.
This is what we accumulated in the O.J. Simpson investigation.
Almost every inch of this warehouse contains evidence pointing to what Deere calls the one overlooked suspect in the deaths of Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman.
Which happens to be O.J. Simpson's son, Jason Lamar Simpson.
How did you get Jason Simpson's Jeep?
We washed it for a period of time after the murders when he put it into storage, hiding it. And then he sold it to a friend, and we had a friend of ours buy it.
And he's been begging the Los Angeles Police Department to collect DNA samples from it and investigate it ever since.
So you have the Jeep.
Yes.
But what's in this box?
What's in this box contains the most crucial piece of evidence that we needed in this investigation, and that's, to us, the murder weapon.
Deere says he obtained a box in Jason Simpson's storage unit in L.A. when it went up for auction because of lack of payment.
And in that box, at the bottom of it, was this knife, a replica of a Gerber Mark V designed for one purpose and one purpose only, and that's to cut and to kill. You can see the top of the survival knife has been removed. It matches the lacerations on the top of Nicole Simpson's skull.
He says Jason Simpson was enraged the night of the murders because Nicole Brown Simpson canceled dinner reservations at the last minute at the restaurant where Jason, a chef, was going to prepare a meal for the family.
If you have a son who's 24, 5'11", 235, and on probation for assaulting his previous employer with a knife, who's been in a psychiatric unit, who was taking Depakote to control his rage disorder, who had attacked two women, and you don't interview him, that's a sad miscarriage of justice.
And this knit cap.
And then there's the black knit cap.
This kind of a cap was found at the crime scene, and it contained hair from an animal and hair that was not O.J. Simpson's. But when you look at this picture up there, there's Jason Lamar Simpson in bed wrestling with his dog. Similar cap, if not the exact same cap, found at the crime scene.
Deere says the LAPD won't test the hair follicles in the cap and compare them to Jason Simpson's DNA.
These are all part of the O.J. Simpson investigation.
From boxes and boxes of evidence.
It's the year of the knife for me.
To Jason Simpson's diaries.
It could have been very instrumental in helping the LAPD solve this unsolved case.
Deere is pleading with detectives just to take another look.
What do you say to the people that are watching this, who watched the trial of the century? They're gonna say, this guy's just crazy. Can we believe him?
I've been inducted to the Police Officers Hall of Fame as a private investigator, one of the only ones that's been inducted. I'm pro-policeman. This is my nickel. I spent the money. Nobody's paid me. Nobody's coerced me in any way whatsoever. I have nothing to gain other than the fact I'm trying to bring truth, which nobody got a chance to see during the trial.
Deere says he'll continue to go down this road, collecting evidence and prodding the LAPD to look at OJ's son.
They want me to go away. I'm not going away, Walt. I've been here for 23 years, and I'm going to go until the day I die.
And he wants to send a message to Jason Simpson.
I'd like to sit down with him, look him square in the eye, and tell him, you ruined your dad's life. You've ruined yours. Finally man up to what you've done so that you can live with yourself.